I'm Kelly Hunsel, PIO for St. Charles City Fire Department, and today we're here to talk about adding emergency medical information into your smartphone. For years, people have used tools such as medical alert bracelets or perhaps medication lists that they carry with them to be able to provide first responders with information that's pertinent to their medical history. With the advent of smartphones, though, this is a great opportunity for us to be able to store not only emergency contact information, but also pertinent medical history that could be used in the case of an emergency. One of the easiest ways to do this is to create an ICE contact. ICE stands for In Case of Emergency, and this can be easily done by putting the letters ICE in front of the contact that you'd like us to use in the event that there's an emergency, so that we can search through your phone and find that information easily. By adding emergency medical information, though, this gives us access to medical information when maybe we can't gain access to your phone. Some phones have security features, though, whether it's a passcode or facial recognition software, that makes it difficult for us as first responders to gain access to your phone if either you're unresponsive or not able to do that for us. The great thing about the emergency medical information is that that can be accessed by first responders from the emergency home screen. That way we never actually have to open your phone to get to that information. So let's walk through those features so you can see how to set it up on your smartphone. Accessing the emergency medical information can be done in one of two ways. You can either go to your settings and scroll down to the Health tab, or you can access the Health app itself from your home screen. From here, you can set up your profile, including your name, date of birth, height, and weight. So once you have your health information stored, you can open Health and go to the Medical ID tab. We're going to hit Edit, and we can add lots of different information inside of this. So it should drag over your name and date of birth from the contact information that we already added. You can list out medical conditions, medical notes, allergies or certain reactions, as well as adding your blood type, whether or not you're an organ donor, and your height and weight. You can also add an emergency contact from this site. So if I, as a first responder, want to access this information from your phone, what I'll do is swipe up on your home screen and you'll see that I'm prompted to enter the passcode. Since I don't know that, what I'll do is hit the emergency button at the left lower corner and it will bring up an option for medical ID. When I hit the medical ID, it'll list your pertinent information, including medical notes, allergies, medicines, including emergency contacts at the bottom. For a Samsung device, it's very similar. You'll add your contact information through your contacts when you choose your name, and you'll set up your medical information. When I, as a first responder, open your home screen and go to emergency call, you'll see that your medical information is then stored. For more information, contact the fire department.